Hi, I'm Eliana, and this is what my day-to-day looks like. Whether it be preparing to go to church, heading to school, or going to work, this is what my daily lifestyle would look like. Everyone's dealing with the situation of Corona differently. People today have lost their jobs, lost opportunities, and many other things it may be. It can be either for the good or for the bad. I genuinely believe that it'll change us as people for the better. These bad experiences are a learning experience within ourselves to learn differently because we were too comfortable. Although it has been difficult to keep up with, that doesn't stop me from continually spreading the word of God online. I am currently working on an amazing project with the church. It's called Cyber Camp. And it's awesome to be able to teach the kids some Bible stories that they haven't heard of yet. It was for sure hard for me at first, having to commute with a face mask and having to put hand sanitizer almost every minute, but it's going to get better once we reach stage 3. It's getting easier for me to cope with, and I think this can apply to everyone else. A lot of things are, of course, different, but that doesn't mean we can't cope with it or handle it over time. I try my best to keep up with myself and my own life. You might think it isn't a lot, but this has been taking over my life as a big wave in a storm. When the outbreak started in March, where quarantine was forced on all of us, I had lost a lot of motivation, leading into not wanting to do my schoolwork, not wanting to do my chores, not wanting to see my friends, and for sure, because of my loss in motivation, I had lost time. I wasted a lot of my time when I could have been doing better things for myself. This leading to a loss of friends and realizing that they weren't the real ones to begin with. I think a lot about my purpose here on Earth, and I question a lot what I'm meant to do or what I'm necessarily supposed to do. Starting September, I'll be going into grade 11, so my third high school year. Shocking, right? And I'm still unsure about my career path. I never want to disappoint when doing my work, and I always try my best to strive for the best. But I guess, recently, that feeling hasn't been there. It's been really boring to stay at home and to distance myself from the people I truly want to see and the things or areas I want to visit. It's been stressful, almost, to be constantly pushing yourself to come out a better person. And although it may be a pain right now, it'll all be worth it to our God's eyes. The Yana in January 2020 is definitely not the same person as of July 2020 Yana. I've learned a lot the hard way over the course of multiple months being in quarantine. I let negative things seep into my head while being isolated for the first few weeks inside. I really didn't know what to expect while maintaining to cope with these kinds of things. However, it's for sure been getting easier and easier as we try to smoothly go back to how our world used to be. What the Holy Spirit has been teaching me is that pleasing the eyes of the world and of our society will give me temporary happiness and won't last for long. I had realized that the standards of our world will constantly be rising higher and higher over the course of time, and one simply couldn't keep up with that. It doesn't bring me benefit, and I realized that over time. I thought that I had to see people and to be able to talk to them in real life would make a greater difference to them. With this project of Cyber Camp, I noticed that I can still make a difference by teaching those kids and being able to do that without seeing them or hearing them in real life. Over the course of months, I've strengthened my relationship with my family. I started to open myself up more and to have more conversations with them. Even if it's as small as a, "How was your day today?" My family has become a strong backbone to me while I've been dealing with my own situations right now. I've gained stronger and more real friendships over time as well. My friends are truly the people I can go to whenever I do need the inspiration or some cheering up if I needed any. They were more than glad to give that support to me and notice that about me when I hadn't said anything about what happened or what's wrong. Going to the church and having to work for him and doing these amazing kinds of things in the environment with the great homies here have been making my deeper connection and the relationship with God even stronger. I'm thankful for my family, my friends, and the homies. This pandemic made me learn that it's really okay to make mistakes. It's fine to become more independent from the world and to distance yourself to what you think isn't good or meant for you in the end. Getting back up from these bad experiences or the mistakes we make and building positive progress is better. Building a better relation to people and things that genuinely better your well-being is stronger than having fake friends and things of this world. It's not only better for your well-being, but it's better for us when it comes to ourselves physically, mentally, and spiritually. This was only a challenge, but it isn't an impossible challenge to overcome. As much as I want to foresee the future, I still don't know what to expect with what's to come. This was for sure a sticky situation in history. This is a sort of situation that we are experiencing during our lifetime, which brought a shock to the world. No matter what we have lost or what we may have gained, we'll have come out as different people for the better. With these sticky situations everyone's facing, we all for sure will come out as different versions of ourselves that we didn't know we could meet. Things won't go back to how it was in January, and they will not be the absolute same once COVID is over. But I can tell you that we'll all come stronger in our faith and stronger in our hearts and minds. And I'm truly thankful for the people in my life, the kind words they have, and the silly moments they bring. I especially give thanks to the Lord, who has always been there for me, even when I don't realize it. I give glory to Him, and I give my honor and praise to Him only.